Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss accessor properties. This is a property other than the data properties that we have used to mention the key value pairs of an object. In order to handle the accessor properties, we have two approaches. The first one is to use the get and set keywords to really set up the accessor properties. The other approach is to use the object.define property function to help create the accessor properties. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is very simple. I just have a title and a heading. And this HTML file is connected to a JavaScript file called myscript.js, which is put in the JS folder. And in order for me to use the strict mode, I have to say use strict on the first line of my JavaScript file. And now I'm going to create some accessor properties. Let us see this example. Now I have a vehicle object shown here. And the vehicle object is quite simple. I just have one key value pair. So this kind of key value pair relationship is called the data property of an object. So I mentioned the vehicle type, and the type is just a bus. So when I have this kind of key value pair, we say that we have some data property given to the object, which serves to be a getter of data properties as well as a setter of the data properties. So how can we do the getter and setter? By using the get and set keyword. Let me show you an example now. Now this is the simple getter. I have the word get, and I have a name from accessor called type name. And if I want to use the getter, I would just return the content called vehicle type. So I would have the bus value coming out from this statement shown here. Okay. So this is the getter. And how about doing the setter? The setter is just using the same name called type name. So the setter is quite simple as well. I use the same name as the getter does, and I want to set the name of my vehicle object. So the new type parameter is something to be passed to my setter function. Okay, so how can I handle the setter? I have to check the length first. If the length is 0, I would just say that the setting of the name is not allowed because I don't allow empty input. If the length is not 0, that means the length of the new type parameter is really larger than 0, and it just means that the name is really passed to the type name function. And I just do the assignment as follows. This dot vehicle type becomes the new type. Okay. So this is the setter. And I've set up the getter and the setter. And how can I use them? Let me show you now. Let me show you the getter. When I use the type name in this way, I'm just able to use the getter component of my accessor property. So then let me save and let me reload. Okay, let me check. Oh, I forgot to put a comma before I do the set function shown here. So let me put a comma and let me save it and reload the page again. Yes, you can see that this is a bus has come out because I just used the getter component of my accessor property whose name is called type name. So when I use vehicle.type name, I would just call the getter part. Okay. And of course, this dot vehicle type is coming from the key value pair, which is of course a data property. And how can I use a setter? Let me show you now. Vehicle.type name equals motorcycle. So the type name here becomes a setter. So when I do an assignment in this way, I'm trying to set my vehicle type to motorcycle. So this motorcycle becomes the value passed to the new type parameter. After setting the motorcycle to be the type name, I have to really get the type name again. So let me show you how to get it. After using the setter, I'm trying to use the getter again. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that this is a motorcycle, so the type name becomes motorcycle, and you can see that the setter works. And the getter is just verifying the successful assignment from the setter. And let me check another situation of the setter. Now I try to set up the vehicle type to be an empty string, which should not be allowed according to the setter shown here. I would be able to show an alert window saying that the input is not allowed. So let me see if it is really the case or not. So let me save and reload. Yes, you can see that when I go to this line, I'm able to see that the empty input is not allowed statement coming out because I just execute this component of my setter function. And of course, when I do the alert window again using the getter part of the type name function of the type name property, I'm able to see that the motorcycle value isn't changed to an empty string. So the type name still remains to be a motorcycle, because this assignment fails according to the setter function shown here. Okay. Let me show you the other way of doing the access properties. The other way is called object.define property. So suppose I have a certain simple object like this one. How can I use this function to do the access properties? Let me show you now. Okay, this is the way to call the object.define property function. So I have to indicate the object first in the first parameter, and then I have to set up the accessor property name called age now, and I'm able to set the getter, which just gives me a statement shown in this way, which tells me the age of that person coming from the key value pair of that object. And I'm also able to set up the value of the age by doing the setter part of the accessor property. So how can I use the getter and setter using the define property function? Let me show you the way. Suppose I use the getter part right now, alert person.age now, save, reload. Okay, this is the original alert window that I haven't commented out. And you see, age becomes 68 because the age now property here is an accessor property to help me get the content from an object called person. So I can get the age according to the getter component shown here. So let me change here. And let me comment out this part as well. Okay, how can I use the setter of the accessor property? Let me show you now. Now I do the setter component. So person.age now becomes 43. So 43 is passed to the value parameter. And this value parameter is going to change the age of the person object. Of course, after the assignment using the setter component, I have to use the getter component to see whether the age has changed or not. Save. Reload. Yes, age becomes 43. So the age now property can act as both the getter and the setter. It depends on the way you use that accessor property. If you use it in an assignment style, it becomes a setter. If you use it as the result coming from an alert window, it would become a getter. So this video has already discussed the accessor property by using the get and set keywords, as well as using the object.define property function, which is a built-in one. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.